Hello everyone, my name's Ryan and welcome back to another Warrior Wednesday. And today we're going to take a look at Sun Wukong. It's actually one of the warriors I like to play sometimes because he can be very, very, very annoying. If you build him tanky enough, he can just continue to poke, damage, poke, damage, and sometimes get away quite easily. And how he gets away, we'll get back to later. It will be to start off with his passive, and that is not something that has to do with his ability to escape. Well, actually it does a bit. When he's below 35%, he will get additional protections, and he will actually get crit chance. He will get 10% crit chance, and he will get an additional percent for each level. So at level 1 he will get 11% of additional crit chance and protections, and at level 20 he will get 30 additional protections and crit chance if he's below 35%. So if he's above 35% health, it actually does nothing for him. His first ability is his cudgel. He will smack in a line, hit everything. Does additional damage to minions and jungle camps. It was a buff for him because his clear was quite terrible. It does 25% additional damage on minions and jungle camps. But it also is a very good ability to poke the enemy. That's also a reason why they nerfed it damage wise to guards. And after that buffed it with the additional damage on the minions. Because it's fairly hard to miss. You can adjust your aim during the entire casting, so it's actually very difficult to miss your one. Because you can actually adjust adjust your aim according to the movement of the enemy. It is still possible to miss because they can juke in a way you don't expect, but since you can use it. As you can see here, I'm going to move forward to the Neith. She used her escape to get a root. A weave, that's what it's called. To get a weave on the ground, but I was not able to get close enough. She was actually pretty fast. You can see a stun on the enemy, Chuck, and we were able to get him for first blood. So let's continue. Go over his second ability. His second ability is in a circle around him. It's not too large, it's very much close range. It is a damaging ability that also slows. It slows for 30% for 2 seconds, so it's a fairly good slow. But it's not doesn't got anything other than that that's really special or anything. His third ability, however, is an ability that's really unique to him in that regard. Because it is the only ability that has 3 forms on your single cast. So what it means is the way you aim your 3 make sure what part of it you use. As you can see here, I tried to do it. I'm casting my 3 very fast, so you can't see it too much. That's a really unfortunate thing I didn't think about by making this one, but it has 3 stages. If you move far away, then you would be in your eagle form. It is your escape form. With that you will do nothing damage wise, but it's a very fast moving. You'll be immune to roots and for slows, so it's very easy to get away with it. However, you can still be CC'd during that dash, so it can be difficult sometimes, but it's very fast. It's quite reliable. As you can see here, I used another form. This is the second form. You move forward. Usually it's a tiger, but with this skin it's something else. But if you hit, you will stun the first target you hit, and it will deal a good amount of damage. A very good amount of damage. It's the hardest hitting one from the three possibilities. As you saw that I used the eagle one, that's the one that you move forward very fast. The last one is an ox. It is the one that's close. If you aim close to you, you will turn into an ox. You will knock up any of the enemies that are in front of you. If they get hit, they will be knocked up in any direction. Actually, they will be knocked aside. So the direction is not always the same. So it's not really, it's not too reliable. It usually throws them a bit back from you. But it's not too reliable to set anything up. But it's a very good escape, because if you go through the enemies, they will be knocked aside, knocked up in the air for a while, so they can't chase you, and you will actually move faster in your ox stance, as well as your tiger stance, your second, the one in the middle, and your bird is very fast. You can see here, Chuck ulting. I am going to try and peel for my team. Fortunately enough, the Chuck gets pushed away, and we're not able to pick up anyone at all. But they are able to pick up two of our teams, so that's rather unfortunate. So his three, he has three ways to use. So what way you use it can be very important, because there are various situations where you rather go for the ox to escape than the than your eagle, because your ox also provides the slow and the root immunity, but it also provides knock up and knock back immunity, and with that additional immunity you will be able to get away a lot better, because you can't be knocked out of it by, for instance, an honor impale. If you go for an honor in your tiger form, the chance is very high that he will just impale you, and you won't be able to get close to him. But if you use your ox form, even though you won't stun him, it will be able to finish him. And as you can see, I used my bird to get away. It's extremely fast, and they did use a lot on me. As you can see, my first item is Bluestone. It's actually one of the few gods I picked Bluestone on, because especially since it's not Conquest, getting Bluestone isn't always worth it. But since every single ability from him does damage, it just provides you a lot of additional damage. And it actually helped me finishing off some gods. I'm not sure if it happened in this game, but it is a very good item on him. Just because every ability is multiple targets. Maybe not his tiger form, but other than that, definitely a lot of it. And as you can see, I'm not really looking to auto attack him. I'm just going to hit him with my cudgel, finishing him off. As you can see, the aim can be adjusted during the entire casting, so that's really nice. As you can see, I try to use my tiger, but tiger form is the only form where you're not immune to slows and roots. So the Nox was able to root me and cripple me immediately, preventing me from moving forward with my tiger form. Any of the other forms wouldn't have happened that way, because I would have gotten the immunity from those forms. Let's continue with his last ability, his ultimate. He charges up a bit. He gets into the clouds. He will become invisible for the enemy, can't be targeted or anything. He will leave behind a clone of him. His clone will actually go and attack the enemy, either minions, towers, but preferably gods, to do the damage. It will do a good amount of damage, actually. It will do half your auto attack damage. So if you would go out of your cloud and attack with your decoy in addition, you will do 1.5 your regular damage with your auto attack. So after you go into the cloud, you will regain health per second. You will regain 5% of your health, maximum health of course, per second. And the amount of healing you get depends on how long you stay in the cloud. There is a limited duration, so if that expires, you will go down with a slam, because that's what that is what happens. And as you can see here, I was able to get away. Not really too much to see, to follow up. And I also have a good amount of defense against enemies. So, but as you can see here, I am charging my ult. As you see, I am in the air. I have a large area where I can come down to, and the charger the timer indicates I can't stay too long, much longer. I didn't want to land in an Isis ult or too far into the enemy lines. I do have my escape, but I didn't have too much health. They already picked up the Divine Rune, which limits the healing I get from my ultimate. But it still did a good amount of healing. So it heals. It will leave the decoy. The decoy can actually be killed with crowd controls. If you CC it with any CC, it will just vanish. And you will be revealed in your cloud. So they will know, they can see what way you're aiming. So if you get rid of the decoy, you can actually see where he's probably going to go to. He can change his direction at the last second, of course. But still. You can see I am forced to use my beads. And again, using the bird, I'm fairly safe. I'm just able to get out quite easily. The enemy Isis, I think, actually picked up the Divine Rune. And it's a bit annoying because it will reduce the amount of healing I can do with my ultimate. But since it is down, it doesn't really matter too much. And as you can see, slows do also apply in your tiger form. As I said, you don't have the slow and the other immunity. And again, the cudgel able to finish it off. So the cudgel is very good at poking the enemy and maybe finishing them off if they are low enough. And that's what something you see me do a lot. I will just continue spamming my cudgel on the enemy just to wear them down, trying to poke them, reduce their health, either forcing them back or just reducing the health for the next engagement. You can see a good amount of damage, and you see the additional ticks from Mystical Mail and my Blue Stone. You can also see I did use my 3 while I was looking down a lot. I wanted to make sure I got into my Ox form immediately, knocking up any enemies that was in front of me, and I was able to get out. Tiger form wouldn't have done anything for me, and the risk of being rooted at that point was a bit too high to go into. Well, actually the eagle wouldn't have allowed it, but and they don't have a knockback, so I could also have used the eagle, but I elected to go for the ox because it also provides some crowd control. But as you can see here, a nice stun. I actually used my bird form here to try and get away, but the enemy Najah was able to sash me, preventing to get away. So you can still be CC'd in those forms, it's just very difficult. As you can see, the sash damage is there. It was the thing that prevented my escape. It's rather unfortunate. At this point we're behind a bit, it's not a lot, but the enemy Chalk is quite tanky and we are probably focusing a bit too much. As you can see, I get into the sky, go down immediately. It does damage on landing, and the Blue Stone actually finished her off, so that's really good. Additional damage from my decoy could help. I haven't really seen him, but that's alright. So you can choose to use it as a chase tool or a high damaging tool, because you will leave the decoy. You don't always have to use it as the health regen, but it's a good feature to use, that's for sure. As you can see, I tried to hard commit. My team wasn't on the same page. They were again focusing the Chalk, and I am saying it because at this point it's not effective at all. He has healing, he is quite good with using his 1-2 combo as an escape, his axe throw and teleport to his axe to get away out of the sticky situations, and with him having enough defense, it's not effective for our team to go for him every single time. So that's why I told my team, try not to focus him. He is in the front line, but you can use a bit poke on him, but don't commit everything on him, and ignore him if there are more important targets that are quite easy to get to. As you can see, I am every single time looking for those squishier targets, using my cudgel, using my stun, trying to wear them down to a point that they will do a lot more, a lot less, because they have less health. And they weren't able to pin me down at this point, so I wasn't even in any trouble at all. I did have my beat still, so if I got shadow locked, I would just beat it and run away. Let's go over the build. It's a bit late to go over the build, but I have built a lot at this point. Like I said in earlier episodes, the builds for warriors are more counter builds than just straight up I built one thing because it's very powerful on them. It very much varies every single game depending on what gods you're against, what warrior you are actually playing, etc, etc. I went for the blue stone because every single ability deals damage from Sun Wukong, just provides a lot. I went power boots because the same reason, it just provides an insane amount of damage. Sun Wukong isn't reliant on his auto attacks, even though his passive does provide critical chance below a certain percent touch health, but it's not something you want to build him as. It's not very effective. He can be very strong just building him tanky and just wear down the enemy. As you can see, I went for the mystical mail. I'm not sure if it was the best thing to pick up because we aren't fighting a lot close to each other. Probably would have been better if I picked up something like picking up, for instance, a Midgardian mail to get rid of the auto attackers, or another like, for instance, Sovereignty, because it also provides defense for my team. So it wasn't the best choice, but as you can see here, good combination of abilities with the Soul 2, we're actually able to pick up the enemy Nox. I am ulting up, slamming down. I was not able to pick someone up, but as you can see here, I am trying to stun her. She used her beats quite effectively and I use mine, and I just finish her off with my 2, since it does a good amount of damage. I'm trying to dodge, and as you can see, I use my Ox form again. Neith is charging up her ult, but my team is there to help, and since I went besides the wall, she was not able to get the vision on me. Probably wouldn't have been enough to finish me anyway, because I have the additional defense. I had about 400-500 health left, and that's really enough with the defense to don't die from an enemy Neith's ultimate. Especially if she can't charge it up completely, she wouldn't have been able to kill me at all. My fourth item is actually auto attack based, but that's because Sun Wukong is fairly good at when he uses tiger form to stun someone. If you just use one auto attack, use your 2, do another auto attack, use your 1, you can do a lot of ability cancelling, so you can get the maximum amount of damage out of everything, and that's very effective. And with the additional slow, it's very difficult to get away for some gods. So I can just continue to stick to someone, try to kill them. As you can see here, I am moving forward. I was trying to go for the enemy Isis, and as you can see, I used my ultimate. But unfortunately enough, I didn't have enough range. At this point, I am pillar hugging, trying to prevent being hit, and it is actually fairly effective. I'm able to get out, but as you can see here, our Anubis was actually picked up by the Neith, but the Neith already got punished for it. I'm now finishing off my beats. I didn't have enough gold for the Titan's Bane, and since beats are also very important, especially with the Nox is very, very annoying for me to deal with, because if she roots me before I am able to use any of my forms, I can't get away. And as you can see, engaging with my escape led into my demise at this point, because I got in with it, I got rooted a lot, I got rooted for such a long time, I was not able to move, and that really, really, really hurt a lot. They have Nox shadow lock that can root, Neith her spirit arrow that can root, they had a lot of slows, they also have the gem of isolation on Isis, if I am correct, so that's just an insane amount of control to keep me in one spot. I was not able to get off my ultimate. I'm not sure if it was up, actually. I think not, because I used it on the Isis and trying to chase her down. So it's rather unfortunate. 2 deaths that actually didn't need to happen if I played it a bit more. If I played it a bit better. But it's still a god. I don't pick up too much. So, yeah, give or take, it is going fairly well. I also went for the Jotuns. Jotuns is just a very good item to just use your abilities a lot more, because I have a good amount of strong abilities, and with additional control. As you can see here, I was trying to tiger form another god, but they were able to get away. And I just dunked down, as you can see, 400 damage on the ultimate, and it's... That was also really unfortunate, I was not able to use the right form. That's the downside of casting it that fast. But also, she used her escape, so I wasn't able to get her anyways. My fifth item actually, or last item, last slot at least, is the Heartward Amulet. I needed some magical defense, I could have gone for the Bulwark of Hope. Also been a good item, but I figured this would also help out my team a bit with the physical defense. I was a bit hesitant about what to take, but the part of my team helping with the additional defense just pushed me over the edge. Otherwise I would have gone for Bulwark, but it's also a bit more expensive, so I wouldn't have been able to pick it up as early. Also went for Titus Bane, just because every single ability will do a lot more damage with it. It's still not an insane amount of damage. As you can see, actually a fairly odd interaction. I think what happened there was I simultaneously got hit by Nox Brute as I used one of my forms that actually provided the slow immunity, and an insane amount of chaos. As you can see, unfortunately enough, we just barely lost. We had 1 point left. I should have just dunked down, tried to kill the Najal before the enemy was able to pick up that one single minion they were able to pick up. So it was very close, a bit of misplay on my part. But I was also a bit hesitant and didn't know how much points were on both sides, so it was a bit risky. As you can see, a lot of damage coming out, only outdamaged by our Sol, and Sol is just an insane amount of damage dealer. As you can see, a build oriented to do damage with abilities and trying to stay alive. I wasn't building too tanky. There could have been a few items I could have picked up to build myself a bit more tanky. The Breastplate of Valor is a good substitute to the Jotuns, just because it provides the cooldown reduction as well, and it provides you with some physical defense. A good item to pick up for Sun Wukong as well is the Mill of Renewal, because if you finally kill someone, you will get a good amount of regen, so you can stay in the fight a lot longer. So if you build Frostbound and other than that, and boots, a lot of defense items, you just continue to stack on the enemy. You also see me pick up my second active, that's an Shield of the Underworld. It's fairly effective on Sun Wukong because he can take a little bit more damage. And if they focus a lot on you, you will deal a good amount of damage back to the enemy. The enemy Chalk also picked it up. It's fairly effective because, especially my team, in the early game, focused him a lot. And that allowed him to do a bit more damage to him. Also, it denied the lifesteal from Anubis and as well as Sol, so it's fairly effective. Fortunately enough, we were not able to pick up a win. It's a bit risky always to pick up an Anubis in arena. As you can see, he was a bit focused down. He's standing still for a lot of his abilities, and since they have a Neath with his Brood, Najah's Sash, Spearball from Isis, and Noxed 1, all very easy to hit abilities if you're standing still. Anyway, so hope you guys learned something about Sun Wukong, how I like to play them. I like to play him a bit more aggressive, and for you to do that, you need to build him a bit more tanky. And to be relevant in terms of being annoying, trying to peel for your teammates, you only had the only real CC you have is with your Ox, and the slow you have with your 2, and your Tiger form, of course. Your third ability, the Tiger and the Ox form, are peel abilities because they can stun or knock up, and your 2 can slow the enemy. But if you use those, you don't really have a lot, and the stun is also single target, so it's a bit difficult sometimes to peel for your team. That's why the Frostbound can be very helpful in that case. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed, and as always, good luck, have fun, and I'll see you guys in the next one.